Here with Jumaane Williams. He is a New York City Council member, soon to be candidate for public advocate, right?
That's correct. That is correct. We announced our intention should Tish James just become the first black elected woman attorney general. Just got the text that actually has happened, so we're excited. So we'll be announcing officially after we enjoy these wins and mourn the losses.
Let's talk about the wins first. We're here at the victory party for Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. Your thoughts on her historic victory, the youngest woman ever elected to Congress?
It's simply amazing. I mean, this here in New York State and even across the country, her win inspires so many people who are trying to figure out if they can ever go against the machine. She said, you can not only go against it, you can win. If you organize, if you have the right message. And so I'm excited. I was excited on primary day. I'm excited now. What I hope we do is get away from kind of saying, well, let's see what she does now. We got to see what we're going to do, because we can no longer just elect people and walk away. We have a tendency to do that. We elected her. We have to now continue to give her the strength she needs to get in a place that is tough terrain for anyone, much less someone who's just coming in. But that's the kind of fresh ideas that we need. We just have to make sure we continue to empower her.
You just ran against the machine. You ran for lieutenant governor, and I'm wondering what you took away from that race. That was a heated race. I mean, your opponents ran attack ads against you that mentioned you having personal debt, as if that was like a knock on your candidacy. What did you learn about running against establishment Democrats in that race, and how can the lessons you've learned help candidates across the country? Like, what can they take away from that?
Well, I think when the debt, when discussing my foreclosure, I think she gave me a couple of points, since so many people in this country and this state are dealing with debt or dealing with foreclosure, and it's actually something I've never hidden. I actually talk about it because I want people not to be ashamed and seek the assistance that they need. But what we knew about establishment Democrats, we've always known. Unfortunately, they are much closer. They use the Republican playbook much more often than we care to admit. And, you know, here in New York State, we wanted to make sure that the Republican governor candidate didn't win. So I told everyone to work and work at the Families Party. But we have to hold these Democrats accountable, particularly the establishment Democrats and the corporate Democrats, where incumbency protection is the only thing they really care about, at the expense of the people of New York City, of New York State. And, you know, I always say we didn't get to this place of the Orange Madness simply because of Republicans. In many areas, we got it because of Republicans who refused to have the courage to stand up. So now that we did what we had to do in New York State, we have to hold this governor, this lieutenant governor, accountable. The criticisms I put forth still exist. Leadership takes courage, it takes vision, it takes risk. We have to demand that our Democrats do that. The seats they hold can't be more important than the people they're serving.
Looking at the overall picture tonight, the Democrats will take the House. What are your thoughts on the national picture tonight?
You know, I'm mourning because there's a few governor's races that we should have gotten in Maryland, where you're from, obviously in Florida. I really thought we were going to get that one. In Georgia, that seems to be a huge case of voter suppression that was going on. But, you know, taking the House, I think, is a bright light in that at least somewhere in America people are saying we're going to repudiate and reject what is going on in this country right now. And just back to your past question, you know, the race that we ran, if I had four additional points, we would have won.
That's right.
And we came closer. We got more votes than any non-white candidate ever in a statewide primary. Yeah. We won New York City. My opponent had over $2 million. The governor had $30 million, spent about $10 on my opponent. I raised about $350,000.
Yeah.
That shows that even though people told me my message wouldn't work, being a principled elected official, having a vision that is not about pay to play, but about the people, that showed me, and the lesson was, and I hope you take away, people are ready for this kind of leadership. People are ready for the vision that puts folks first. And we don't have to do the pay-to-play, and we don't have to play politics as usual. People are intelligent enough, and they're ready for it. And I hope we take that lesson moving forward.
Jumaane Williams, thanks very much, and best of luck with your candidacy for public advocate.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.